Hello, hello, welcome back to my channel and to today's video where I am going to tell you all about my refer brushes. The reason why I'm doing that is because I recently got 4 more eye brushes and I wanted to show you the full collection, talk a little bit about the brand and let you know what my favorites are. So if you're interested to know more about refer brushes, then please keep on watching. Let's start with me telling you a little bit more about how I came to stumble upon refer brushes a few years ago, it must be over a year ago now. They started a Kickstarter program and I think I heard it first from either Beauty News or Mel, but I think Beauty News, and they were talking about it on Beauty News saying that there was this new brush company owned by 3, I think they are engineers, but they're all male, no females, no makeup artists, nothing to do with makeup, but they were so intrigued by the artistry of crafting these makeup brushes that they were like, that's interesting. If we combine it with our knowledge about engineering and we are going to ask the community what they would love, then we can create the best brushes ever. Well, I don't know if they are the best brushes ever, but they are really, really good. And I want to just go over the type of collections they have. There are 2 collections at the moment. They have the core collection, and I'm going to read off a little bit of their website what they are saying about it. They say it's a 5 do-it-all brushes that will instantly elevate your makeup experience in a luxurious way. The brushes that are in this collection are the brushes 1 to 5. I think I have all of them except for number 4. And if you order this collection, you get a number 22, that is this bronzer brush. You get this one for free as a complimentary add or gift to your purchase. The whole core collection is $168, and this baby is worth $110 and you get it for free. So I think that is very nice. There's also a pro collection and they say that it's a specialized shapes for when the situation demands unique solutions. Crafted in silver and glossy black pro handles with longer tapered handles and minimal branding. Optimized for the pro environment. So I think they have been talking a lot to pro makeup artists as well to develop these brushes. What I think is really cool that there are a lot of influencers who have been adding their 2 cents about all the designs of the brushes they would prefer. And you can actually add the creator to the brush. So that is kind of fun. I will talk a little bit about that if I know about it, then I will tell you what creator the brush was inspired by. The reason why I really love refer as a brand is because their customer service is very, very good. They keep you notified, they are very polite in their matter of speaking. What they do is they handle the fees as it comes to like taxes and stuff like that. So that I think is very nice. I think it's just in the pricing of the brushes, but I don't mind. I have to pay a lot of taxes to get like brushes, makeup, whatever from all over the world to Europe. So that can be very annoying. And I love it when a brand is already putting the taxes either in the price at checkout or if it's just in the pricing so they can handle taxes. So that I think is really nice. Also, they have a lot of like, not necessarily like sales, but they have these nice deals you can jump on. For example, the P22, that is this brush, that bronzer brush, you get it for free with the core collection. These 4 new brushes I ordered was take one, get one free. Like, okay. And then these 2, I think this is the number 5 and number 19. You could pick 2 brushes from their website, and if you wanted to have the custom handles, you had to wait a little bit longer, but you would get them at a 50% discount, or you got one and got the other free, something like that. So they have always have these very fun deals. I jumped on the brand when they were doing that Kickstarter program. I didn't choose like the most expensive tier, but I chose the $149 tier, and that meant that you could choose like I think 7 or 8 brushes from the bespoke collection, and then I just gradually added to the collection the, you know, the brushes I wanted to get. I'm going over all the brushes and I'm going to tell you in which collection they are. And I think it's the it makes the most sense to me to start with the face brushes and then go over to the eye brushes. And I will just let you know in what collection the brush is, you know, in. I'm going to start off with the number 5. That is this brush. And this is a cheek brush. And I think you could, you know, say it's a blush brush. Of course, you can use it also for bronzing. I really love it for bronzing. You can use it for a contour because it has like this nice tapered shape. And it's really, really soft. You see how it moves on my hand? It's really soft. All of the brushes are. And this is just, it makes blending really effortless. This brush is $57 and it is in the core collection. And what they say is that it's an ultra soft cheek brush that will instantly elevate your face makeup in a luxurious way. This flagship cheek brush has been a community favorite since its debut and is designed for blush, powder, highlight and bronzer applications. I really love that they're not saying this is a blush brush. No, this is a cheek brush and you can use it for highlight, bronze, blush, whatever. So it's not like you are being told what to use it for. No, you can just, it's ideal for the cheeks. That is, you know, that is, I think, really nice. It's handmade and it's using uncut natural hair. So it's not vegan, this brand, but I like to, you know, have some natural hair brushes to my synthetic brushes in my collection. Then the number 19, that's this one. It's a bit of a tapered brush, as you can see. It is a little bit wider in the middle. And if you flip it, then you have like a little, it's a little bit more slanted and you have this tapered edge. And what they say, it's the number 19 and it retails for $48 in the Pro collection. And it's a luxurious candle-shaped cheek brush that's extremely versatile. This brush is incredibly soft. It is, as you can see, again, very easy. The movement is very easy. This brush is incredibly soft and is sloped on all sides to varying degree, providing you with maximum flexibility during application. It's ideal for natural makeup looks. This brush is perfect for blush, highlight, contour, and powder. I can imagine, because you can powder your under eye with this one because of the shape. Highlight is very easy. You don't pick too much up on your brush and you can really buff it in. So that is really nice. And it's also handmade by Japanese master artisans using uncut natural hair. This is a brush I haven't been reaching for a lot because I have some, I put it in my like cup for all my highlighter brushes, but I think I'm just going to switch it to the container I use for my blushes because I really want to try this a little bit more with blushes that are very pigmented and I need a softer application. Then I'm going over to the number 20 brush. This I got, I think, when I was choosing which brush I wanted. It is in that, like, the ferrule is that silver with the gleamy black handle. And it's like worker name was P09B, but it is the brush number 20. This one retails for $28 and is in the Pro collection. And they say that it's a soft and airy fan brush designed for light application of highlight and contour. Precision control allows you to slowly build to desired intensity. It's not completely clean, because I have been using it a bit for highlighter. I do like it as a highlighter brush, but I like it a little bit more as a like the contour brush more. I don't contour a lot, so this is not a brush I use a lot, but if I do, I really like it because, as you can see, I'm not pushing very hard on my hand. The movement of the hairs is very flexible, and I really love that because you can make a very nice blend because of that. If you are someone that loves to apply highlighter with a fan brush, I think you will love this as well. It's not extremely thin, but it's not very thick either. And I think it's a very, very nice brush for $28 because it's also handmade. It's also uncut natural hair. So yeah, I think it's a great price for a brush like this. Then you got the number 22. That's this one. I think now if you get it now, you get it in this type of handle. So the black sleek handle. And this is also in the Pro Collection. If you want to buy this like on its own, it's $110. I stored them a little bit funny and now the hairs are chinking out. So that's annoying. But I think that that will be fixed whenever I'm going to wash it again. I wash this, I have washed this regularly, and this is, it's the softest brush. I have also the Jaclyn Hill brush by Morphe. It's, this one is a lot more fanned out already, and it's like in its shape, it is comparable, but it is no match for this brush. This brush is my favorite out of the whole collection. This is so soft. It blends out your bronzer perfectly. And it picks up a little bit more product than the Jaclyn Hill does. But not too much to make you look like you went overboard. So it's just my favorite. And I think it is very much based on the Tom Ford bronzing brush. They have gone from natural to synthetic hairs. And if you buy it now, the Tom Ford brush, then a lot of people who have both of them say that it's not as good, but this is a perfect replacement for that. What I hear, because I don't have the original Tom Ford, but I hear Mel saying that, I hear Michelle Wong saying that. So yeah, this is a very nice brush, and you get this brush for free if you order the Core Collection. The Core Collection is $168, as I said, and this you get for free. So, but if you are going to pay the $110, I think it is worth it. What they say about it, that it's an incredibly soft and luscious bronzer brush that will instantly elevate your makeup routine in a luxurious way. The largest brush in our collection is incredibly substantial and is ideal for quick contour application of bronzer and powder. I wouldn't use it as a contour brush because it is quite big. It is quite big. It's not going to be precise enough, but the blend... So if you want to be more precise, you can put your contour on with this and you can blend it out a little bit with this, whatever tickles your fancy. But this is my favorite brush. It's like, I don't know. It's so stunning. Then the last one I have in the face category, it's the number 17. And this brush was made with Angelica Nyquist in mind because she likes to have a kabuki brush that is a lot smaller. As you can see, it's like a dense kabuki brush, but it's way smaller than usual. And I love to use this to blend out my cream blushes and cream bronzers. I don't use it for my foundation. I have tried it, but for me, it's just a bit too small. And I don't use a kabuki. Normally, I use something. It's a kabuki as well, but it's like more tapered at the sides and not like a flat top. I prefer this for my foundation, and I prefer this to blend out like creamy cheek products and then mainly bronzer and blush. So I should get another one. This one retails for $45. They say it's a luxuriously soft and densely bundled flat top applicator. This brush is designed with precision in mind and will allow you to effortlessly build coverage in targeted areas. It's also handcrafted and also with uncut natural hair. This is, I think, a very nice addition. If you use a lot of cream products, then this is really nice. Or if you want to apply your foundation with a kabuki brush, then this is very nice as well. It's not my favorite brush in the whole collection. It's just because I only use it when I use blush, cream blush and bronzer, and that is not all the time. Then I'm going over to my eye brushes. I want to say face. Eye brushes. And I'm going to start at the number one brush. And I think that this is the number one. This is the number one brush. This is one of my newer brushes. So I haven't used it yet. And I'm very glad that I'm finally filming this video. So I can, start using it. This one reminds me a lot of... And it's one of my favorite brushes as well. The Wayne Goss number 18. This is a new one as well. You can see it's a little smaller. The shiny one is the Wayne Goss and the matte one is the Reffer. You can see it's a little smaller. And the Wayne Goss, it's new. I haven't used it yet. It's a little a little thinner than the refer one, but both of them I have to work in. But I really enjoy these type of brushes to start in my outer corner and like blend into my crease. I always start with a brush like this. I have the same shape from MAC, and I have one from Sigma, and I'm going to try the Zoeva. I think it's the 231. Don't hold me to it. I'm going to try that as well. But I wanted to have this type of brush, my favorite brush to start my eyeshadow with from Refer as well. And I got this on a deal where I could buy two and get two for free if I waited for this handle, because they also had the shiny handle, the shiny black with the silver ferrule in stock, but I wanted to have the black matte. So I had to wait like 12 weeks or something, and COVID came around, so I had to wait a little bit longer, but I didn't mind because I had a very good deal on this. This retails for $24 and is in the Core collection. They say it's a luxurious multi-purpose eyeshadow brush designed for effortless shading and blending. This brush works equally well with powder and cream products and is also capable of spot concealing and detail highlighting. I can see the reference for the concealer, but I wouldn't use it as a highlighter, but that's just me. The number one is our flagship eye brush that's been carefully calibrated to work for all eye shapes, including hooded and monolids. Then the number two, it's also a new brush for me. This is like a typical shader brush, as you can see. It's not too big. I have something similar from, I believe it's Sigma. Yeah, this is the Sigma E55, and as you can see, it's a lot bigger. And I don't necessarily have very small eyes, but I don't have huge eyes, and they are a little hooded. So for me, it's easy to have like a smaller one as well to be a little bit more precise. I'm really curious to test how this is going to work, because I really want to know how it is going to pick up product. This is the number two, $24, and also in the Core collection. And they say a firm shader brush that is dense and soft at the same time, optimized for maximum pigment payoff. I can imagine. Works with both powders and creams and is perfect for laying down pigments, quick smoky eyes, and delicate work near the lower lash line. Yeah, I can imagine that the lower lash line would be... Yeah, I think the lower lash line would work as well, because it's quite thin. The number two is our flagship shader brush and has been optimized to work for all eye shapes, including hooded eyes and monolids, and is also handcrafted and from natural uncut hair. So yeah, I'm really curious to dig into that one. Then the number three is this very teensy tiny pencil brush. I bought this, I think, when did I get this? I don't really remember, but I made a, after I got the Kickstarter collection in, like the bespoke collection in, I made a few orders, and I think this is the second one I ordered. It's just a small pencil brush, and I love to use this for my under eye, and I think this is one of my favorite brushes to use for my under eye work. What they are saying, it's also $24, and it is in the Core collection, because the brushes 1 to 5 are in the Core collection. It's a fine-pointed and firm pencil brush that is unexpectedly soft. True. Designed for detail work near the most delicate areas, enabling you to effortlessly elevate any eye look with imaginative precision. Brush number three is carefully calibrated to work for all eye shapes, especially hooded and monolids. I can attest to that, because you know, if you have like hooded eyes, you don't have a lot of lid space normally to work with, and you have to get into your fold, and you have to be very precise to make sure that it doesn't blow out too much if you don't want that. And this brush is very, very perfect for detailed work. It's just very small, so it takes you a bit of a while, but you know, that's just because it's very small. But it is, I think, a very nice addition to have in your collection if you are someone that loves to do a little bit more detailed work, or if you have a little bit smaller eye. Then I have the number 13 and the number 14. These I ordered, I think, together, and I might gotten one for free. I don't know for sure what was the deal. The number 13 and the number 14 are both $24, and they're both in the Pro collection. These are calibrated for all eye shapes, but they're targeted for hooded eyes, and that is why I wanted to get them. One has like more of a flat top, and the other one has more of a pointed top. So that is what I really like about it, because you have the same thing with the wing goth, number 20 and 19. It's like the same. I hope you can see, but these are the Wayne Goss ones and these are the Refer ones, and these are just a teensy bit bigger, but I've been using this a lot more. So it could also be because they just fluffed up a little bit more, but it's the same. You have like this flat top and you have a tapered one, and the Wayne Goss ones are just a little bit bigger. Both are, I think, very nice. They're very intertwinable, but these are a bit stiffer. Both $24, both in the Pro Collection, and they are like targeted for hooded eyelids. Then the number 15 is also a newer one for me. It's a blending brush and it's quite dense and quite stiff, so I think it's very nice if you have a very pigmented eyeshadow. It's like you can't really blend out very easily. You can reach for this one. They say it's a versatile medium-sized crease brush built for impactful pigments and effortless blending. That's what I said. And they say it's also handcrafted from uncut natural hair, and it's $24 in the Pro Collection. So yeah, I think it's nice to have something like this that is a little bit stiffer of a blender for very pigmented eyeshadows. Then the number 16 is a bit bigger and is a little bit more pointed, I think, than the 15. You see, the slant is starting over here, and here the slant is starting a little bit bit higher up, which makes it this brush, the number 16, is a little softer than the number 15. It's also a little bit bigger. So I think this would be a nice one to just blend out shadows when you have laid them down and you want to blend them out to make a nice blend. I think this would be a very nice brush for that. They say a large tapered crease brush that's ideal for applying a quick wash of base color on lids. They say that due to its tapered shape and soft bristles, brush 16 is also a pro favorite for detailed highlighting. Oh yeah, I can imagine. I don't do detailed highlighting, but I think maybe on your cupid's bow or your nose, maybe. Also, natural hair and handmade. And then this is a weird one. This is the last one. This is the Refer P21. I can't find this on the website anymore, but this is a brush that is made especially for Mel Thompson, because there is a MAC brush she used to love in the natural hairline from MAC, and they went totally like synthetic, and it doesn't work as well anymore. I don't know what the number of the MAC brush is. If you know them, please let me know, or let us know down below. But this is a brush that came complimentary when I ordered two others, and I don't really remember what that was. I can't find it on the website anymore. I can't find it like as a complimentary brush anymore as well. So I hope this comes back, because I love this brush to pick up shimmer shades. You know, I don't like to work with my fingers when it comes to shimmer, so I either use like this type of brush, or I use my Arrowhead from Smith Cosmetics, or even my what's it called, the Morphe M124. Yep, I use those kinds of brushes, but this is the one who performs the best. It picks up the most product and lays it down very nicely, but the thing is that I wanted to pick up more product than it does, than the Arrowhead or the Morphe does, and it really does. And it's not like I can use any other like concealer brush to do the same thing. It doesn't work like that. It really doesn't work. This is a stunning brush, and I hope they will I hope they will bring it back to their website. All right, guys, that was it from me on my Refer brushes. I hope this helped you a little bit. If you want me to show you how I demo them, I might, but I don't know for sure. But if you want to see more about my brushes, how I use them, how I apply my makeup with them, then please let me know down below. I will be happy to do that. Then thank you for watching. I hope you like what you saw. If you did, then please give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already. And I hope I will see you in my next one. Bye.